going to do take me out to the ball game, and I'd like to play it fast. Mm-hmm. And really, it's just one of these take me out to the ball game things where you just kind of flow with it, which is fun, and I'm going to kind of do it that way at first. But then I'd like to pick it up, because it's just so much fun to play fast. Well, take me out to the ball game. Take me out to the crowds. Buy me some peanuts and some Cracker Jack. I don't care if I never get back. And it's root for the home team. If they should win, it's a shame. Lose really if it's 1, 2, 3 times you're out at the old ball game. Standard. My wife says I'm always negative when I'm up here playing. And I'm negative because my voice is gone. The good thumbnail that I use all the time, I wore down on doing some concrete work, so that's partially gone. And I need new strings.
He's not negative,
so,
right?
Is that enough negativity for tonight?
It's
enough.
It's just excuses.
It's excuses, that's right.
Thank you, Chris.
That's right.
But, come on, G, you can give us some.
I like the standards. And I asked Patrick about the song Georgia. And I said, how would you pigeonhole Georgia? And I even asked Beth that. And he said, well, it's sort of the standard. Okay, so it's a standard. But it's also on a lot of country albums. So you could consider it to be a country song. And it's all in how it's done. So I can do you my version of it.
I see the world comes back to you.
song. It's Georgia on my mind. An old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind. Grand harmonics. Okay. Patrick was talking about hanging out with Janis Joplin and all those cool guys down there. The nice thing about what he ran into was a warm-up session that, actually playing these open mics is harder than doing an actual gig. Because when you do an actual gig, sometimes you get 3.5 hours in the green room if you really want to get warmed up. And this warm-up thing that you came to, it was a sort of a predecessor to that. It was a warm-up. Well, here you come right on, you pick up your guitar and you start playing, and you may or may not be as warm as you'd like to be. But that Woodstock thing, 69, I'm glad I missed it in a way. And in hindsight, you look back and you say, well, that was a zoo out there. Now, Patrick, he really wanted to go to that. Now, Roseanne and I, we were raising 3 kids, and Woodstock wasn't even on our radar. But Patrick and BJ, they were going to go there. And they tried. But what I understand is that they went to the wrong place. And then when they got to the wrong place, it's like the guy in Maine who says, you can't get there from here. So he tried to get there from here, from there, and then he couldn't. And he missed the whole thing. But you had a prelim.
Yep.
You had a trailer to the show, maybe?
What's that?
You call it a trailer to the show?
Yeah.
Yeah, something like that. But the Woodstock thing kind of kicked off the counterculture revolution to the folk scene, which was mainly what I was involved in. And after that, some of the crazy stuff started to be written in the 70s and 80s, and it was sort of a counterculture thing. You had some folk melodies, you had some roots melodies, but they were starting to get over the place, and conventions were starting to fall, and all this and that. But there's one song that came out in 1971, and was recorded by a band called Cimarron, and it's a song that Leo Kottke covers all the time. And we've seen Leo a number of times in some of the shows at Detroit Music Hall and The Egg. And Leo does an iconic version of this song, and he does it so well. It's one of the reasons I like the song, because I can't do anything he does. It's just an incredible amount of finger-picking, and other people in bands will put something on the internet and say, we don't understand how he does it, but this is what he does with this song. So I'm going to do a non-Leo Kottke version of a song called Rings. And Rings, it's kind of interesting how folk music can, or songwriting can just take place where you take a word like ring and you put a number of ring concepts together and you come up with a song. And this was written by a couple of fellas from over in Britain or in thereabouts. And they actually got into the Songwriter's Song of Fame for writing this and some other songs. But I'm going to do my version of Rings. And it's a relationship song. It's about two people that get back together after a fight and they parted. And they have a relationship that's more physical than spiritual, according to the lyrics, but at the end has redeeming value because they get married and the wedding bells ring. Thank you. telephone rings, somebody says, baby, what you doing? Wondering where you've been, now and then I think about you and me. Ain't no use fighting about the things we can't recall, 'cause you know they don't matter now at all. Just come on in, maybe we'll laugh and sing, make love and let the telephone ring. Ring, ring, doorbell ring, come on in, I got Mel Blanc on the radio. Glad you came around, feeling down, talking to Tony and Mario. You know they make good conversation, still there ain't no consolation. 'Cause I got love, maybe I'll give you some. If somebody comes, we'll let the doorbell ring. Sun round your pretty finger. Ring, ring, voices ring, what a happy tune, anyone can be a singer. The sun comes up across the city, swear you never look so young and pretty. Hand in hand, stand upon the sand, reach your man, let the wedding bells ring. Said hand in hand, stand upon the sand, preach man, let the wedding bells ring.
Gene Parzak's, everybody.
Nice.
Cimarron song. I only knew that as Leo Kottke. I didn't realize.
Yeah, well, if you hear Cimarron do it, yeah. The 71 album, it's a soul song.
Cool.
Kottke picked it up with the syncopated beat, and then we end up with my version of it.
Okay. Izzy, you all set? Well, you will be.
I will be.
You will be in a second or two.
That's the one. See you in December.
This is the problem with wireless microphones. The batteries die.
Oh, you just put new ones in.
Well, that was in that one.
Oh.
It must be planned obsolescence.
What kind of batteries do you
need? Well, they were cheap. The ones that came with it were cheap.
Oh, right. Should we go look for some?
No, we got some upstairs.
See,
oh.
It says there.
Something's come up in there every once in a while.
Izzy's going to use that one, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
You want to plug that in?
I can use this mic.
Okay.
That'd
okay.
Plenty. Just use this. This. How's everybody doing tonight?
Very
good. How are you?
I'm good, I think.
Good show.
Find out a second here, since I figure out what I'm going to play. Let's see.
Basically proving what Gene was talking about earlier, that we just show up and...
Tune.
I had a little submarine to
make. I better tune up.
Yeah, please, I can do three songs.
All that, yeah. Sure.
Yeah. Don't have your cheaters on?
Let's see. Well, the first song I have here in my music book is, I'm going to play since it's there, and I'm not going to turn the page because it's, because it wants to be played. So this one's called Save That Rock and Roll. It's an original. Rock and roll dies, it ain't going to be my fault. Rock and roll dies, it ain't going to be my fault. Well, I've done all I can to sport my special car. Won't go out with me to dance that rock and roll. You never go out and dance to that rock and roll. Well, I do believe you've lost your rock and soul. Save that rock and roll. Gotta help me save that rock and roll. Just lend a hand and resuscitate rock and roll. Stay home Saturday nights. Used to go out and rock those city lights. Please take my hand and don't put up a fight. You gotta help me save that rock and roll. You gotta help me save that rock and roll. So stay rock and roll. Can't you feel the beating heart of rock? Knock up those shoes and boogie in your socks. Feel that rocking down the block. You gotta help me save that rock and roll. Gotta help me save that rock and roll. Please lend a hand and resuscitate rock and roll. Please lend a hand and resuscitate rock and roll.
One more time.
Rock and roll. Thank you. Kind of a rockabilly feel for that one, right? Now what am I going to play? Oh no, I don't know. I don't know. I do another one, original, that I actually do need the words to. It's not memorized. I like to actually memorize my songs, particularly with originals, so I don't have to, I can focus more on with the audience, so everyone's like staring at you, so you can stare right back at them, as opposed to stare at the lyric. So, but I'm not quite there with some of these. These are, just haven't played these enough. So this one's called Get On With Your Day.
Day.
shoulder. Truth is, you're getting older. Here is where you may choose to stay. Get on with your day. There's not much more I could say. Time is passing, you've lost your way. So get on with your day. So many miles and cried tears like a child. There's a lot more here at play. Get on with your day. It may be time to rejoice. Is you have no choice. Don't hide from the sun's rays. Get on with your day. Get on with your day now. There's not much more I can say. Time is passing, you've lost your way. So get on with your day. Get on with your day. Thank you.
I have one more here, let's see.
All that with some Johnny Cash.
Yeah.
I hear the train that comes, it's coming around the bend. I ain't seen the sunshine since. I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison. Time keeps dragging on. That train can keep a rolling down the sand. When I was just a baby, my mother told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. When I hear that lonesome whistle, I hang my head and there's rich folk eating in a fancy diamond car. They're probably drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. But I know I had it coming. I know I can't be free. Those people keep them moving, and that's what tortures me. Well, they freed me from this prison. If that railroad train was mine, I guess I'll move it on a little farther down the line. Far from Folsom Prison is where I want to stay. And I let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away.
One drummer can always tell another drummer because he's playing the bass with his right foot. Did you notice? Did you realize you're doing that?
If I only had a bass drum.
Okay. Gene and I are going to do one more song before we close out for the night. But. Yep.
Johnny Cash.
That's Izzy singer, by the way. Izzy?
Yeah.
Is he a singer? Yes, he is. Yeah. I'm sorry.
Are you trying to talk Glendora with a joke?
No, I can't talk Glendora. Okay, I'm gonna.
Now, I practiced 15 minutes with Beth and none with Patrick. He said he's gonna come up with something that will work.
Here, hold on to that for a second, okay?
Why not? There, okay. See, I did something.
Yeah.
How do you play this?
Okay.
What's that? How do you play this, guys?
With my fingers?
Oh, yeah, good.
Okay. Some of them you might have mentioned way back when. I've been only published one time with poetry in my whole lifetime, even though I've submitted more than once. I've only been published one time. And I ended up in this book called Touched by the Blues.
Ooh.
It's called collected and edited by Eli Marcus, who is the founder of Blues for Peace in Israel. Yeah. And so my only publication was in Israel at this point. But he was kind enough to send me a copy of the book a few years ago after it was published, and I had sent him this poem. And this is basically my idea of the blues. It goes like this. The blues are more than a Mississippi crossword, more than Robert Johnson, Charlie Patton, Sonny Boy 1, Sonny Boy 2, more than the Delta fields that gave it birth, more than Chicago with its winds that gave it flight, more than the children it spawned, B.B., Muddy, the Wolf, Willie, Chester, John Lee, more than its followers, Steve, Eric, Jimmy, you, me. When we first encounter the blues, it can be moving, and even a life-defining experience. For some, it may be a cry in the night. For others, the finding or loss of a one true love. Or for some, the reality of eternal emptiness. Whatever brings us to the blues, once we arrive there, we understand, without words. It's the heartbeat of life. It's a song of joy. It's a cry of pain. It's the unmistakable touch of love. It's the naked truth that cleans the soul and sets your heart free.
Nice.
And so I mentioned one person in that book, in that poem, who we all know as Blues Ben Go, and that's Robert Johnson. And I've got the two pictures. And so I'm going to pass them around because this song is based on the two pictures. This is the first picture, and I'm going to pass it back. And this is a picture of him looking kind of disheveled. Okay? About a year later, after he sold his soul to the devil at the crossroads, he came up looking like this. And if you look, he's got a brand new pair of shoes. He's got a brand new suit, and he's got a brand new hat. And so I decided to write this song about that. So, well, you pass that over there so people can look at the pictures. I saw a situation here.
Thank you.
And this is called Brand New Shoes, the one that I wrote a while back. Come on, baby, have you heard the news? I got myself some brand new shoes. I got some brand new shoes. I got some brand new shoes. I got some brand new shoes. I wanna dance with you. Hey,
saying, hey, hey, baby, I'm wearing his hat. I got myself a brand new hat. I got a brand new hat. I got a brand new hat. I got a brand new hat. A pair of shoes. Come on, baby, I wanna dance with you. I said, hey, baby, have you heard the news? I got myself a brand new suit. I got a brand new suit. I got a brand new suit. A brand new suit, hat and shoes. Hey, baby, I wanna dance with you. I said, hey, baby, I wanna dance with you. Hey, baby, I wanna dance with you. Hey, baby, I wanna dance with you. I said, hey, baby, I wanna dance with you. Brand new hat, brand new shoes. Hey, babe, I want to dance with you.
That's it.
<a good one.
laughs> And if anybody else wants to do a song, they can jump up here and sing. If not, I'm going to be here next month, second Friday of the month. I have no idea what that date is, but it's the second Friday of the month.
Yeah.
and thank you, everybody who came tonight and participated, yeah. Everybody who came and listened to us.
Thank you.
Really, thank you for all of your support. We really appreciate it here. Support the Nassau Free Library. We have our Nassau Fest next Saturday, November 16th from 10 to 2. Come on down, buy some books.
Yes.
Oh. Buy some baked goods, listen to some music, and buy some jewelry.
Yes, and if we have any piano players out there, we have a new piano in our
repertoire
donated by Larry here so
hey,
kindly.
Thank you very much,
it's
Larry.
A beautiful keyboard that if you know any piano players out there, it's a full-size keyboard, and we'd love for someone to play it. Oh, Robin! Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
You teach piano. You must
yes.
know how to play it.
I don't play it.
It's okay. We're trying to get Roseanne
to
do it.
You can play easy. You just push the buttons and it'll do it.
Yes, yes.
So again, thank you all very much, and thanks for coming.
36 songs.
Thank you.